This is the difference between a company that's going to give you a great experience in the beginning and for years to come to a company that's going to make you pull your hair out because you can't get someone on the phone. And then you have what I like to refer to as Chuck in a truck. What you should not see is a bright metal junction box, silver junction box next to the system. This video is to help you choose the right solar company for you. How many cars have you owned? How many cell phones? What about homes? Are you on your first, your second, your third? Well, how many times have you bought solar? Probably none, right? Then let's look at 10 questions you can ask a solar company. Hi, my name is Brad with Rea Solar. Today, we're going to talk about how to choose a solar installation company. I'm going to give you 10 questions you can ask a solar company. I've noticed when people are shopping for solar, they can quickly get overwhelmed. What panels are the best, which inverters, with warranties. After all that, you still have to figure out what is the best company to choose, from big companies to small ones to maybe international brands. And the choice is not obvious. I found people realize solar is a commitment. Most solar panels have a 25-year warranty, so they want to make sure they're choosing a company that's going to provide them excellent service 5 years, 10 years from now. After working in the industry for over 10 years, I've thought a lot about the different types of solar companies. I've even worked with one of the biggest ones in the world. As a solar consultant, I've met with thousands of people, and I've probably heard tens of thousands of questions about solar. This video is to help you choose the right solar company for you and for your home. Because remember, your home is not the same as your neighbors and you don't have the same needs as them. My hope, since this video is on YouTube, it'll help people all the way from Boston to California to Australia, Europe, and all over the world. If you do find this video helpful, please click to subscribe. And to be clear, I'm not going to suggest you choose a company like Rea Solar. My goal is to explain the differences between these companies so you have the information you need to make an informed decision. Now, I do understand some people are just shopping for price. I call these people commodity shoppers. All they care about is the lowest price with the most benefits or the most options. And as you know, having the lowest price doesn't always signify quality or longevity. But if that's you and all you care about is the lowest price, then please don't waste your time with this video, because this video is how to choose a quality company that's going to be there, that's going to get the right products, the right selections for your home. If you do just want a low price, there are some really good online websites where you can just type your name and address in and they're going to give you 3 or 4 quotes. I will warn you, if you do choose to work with a company like that, the old idiom does hold true. You get what you pay for. If you don't care about service, if that company's going to be in business in 5 years, or when there's a problem, because this is a construction project with electronics, do you own a modem or computer? You ever had an issue with those? Okay, so you're probably going to have an issue at some point, whether it's a communications or some sort of error with your solar system. How is that solar company going to handle it when that happens? Are you going to be frustrated trying to make call after call and no one picks up the phone? I think you get the point. It's very important you choose the right type of company to install your solar system. If you're still watching this video, then I think things like quality, workmanship, punctuality, integrity, all those things mean something to you. And if those things do, then let's look at 10 questions you can ask a solar company. Some of these questions will apply to any trades company, any construction project you're ever doing. Others are going to be very specific to solar. And when we're done with the questions, I'm going to sort of round it up with just some helpful points again when you're choosing a solar company. So number one, first question, tell me about your company. I mean, this is obvious, right? But you'll be surprised how many people don't even ask the basics about the company that they might enter into a 25-year relationship with. So what about the company? How many years in business? How many employees? What type of corporation are they? Are they S-Corp, C-Corp, LLC? Are they a big megacorp? Do they just cover your town, or are they covering the whole state? Are they a regional company, or are they a big national company? Now, when you're comparing company sizes, I do want to emphasize the biggest company is not necessarily the best. Neither is the smallest company necessarily the worst. I've seen dozens of big companies come in and out of Massachusetts in the last 10 years. They come in, they offer big promotions, they're very slow on install, terrible with service, and then they leave the state or go out of business. I've seen this happen over and over again. In fact, I can't even name one company that stayed in Massachusetts the last 10 years and hasn't replicated that model. In general, I believe there's about three or four types of solar companies. Again, you have the very, very big national companies. You have the regional companies that may cover the entire state or maybe a couple states. You have your small to mid-sized companies. And then you have what I like to refer to as chucking a truck. Chucking a truck is maybe your local electrician. It's just him and maybe one helper who's going to help with the install. Each of these type of companies will have a benefit. If chucking a truck happens to be your neighbor and he can get the system for you, and here's the most important part. If he knows how to navigate the state permitting process so you can take advantage of all the incentives and the projects done right, then that may be the cheapest possible option. Now, he's not going to be there to perhaps monitor the system. He may not understand all the nuances of how the system is working or not, but it may be a cheap option. I found most people feel less comfortable with a company that size. The next level up is your small to mid-sized company. These are companies that may have anywhere from 3 to 4 employees to 10. I see some companies, they're a sales guy who has transitioned to own his own solar company. These type of single sole proprietor operations tend to subcontract all the work out to someone else. And that's not a bad thing. Other companies may be a small electrical firm. We worked with one company for years. It was an older guy. He's been in the solar industry now for about 20 years. Him and now his son's working with him. I'm telling you, if this company does your install, it is going to be pristine. They're really going to do a good job. Now, where they may lack on is on some of the sales experience. They may not have the flashy website or great marketing, but the install itself will be good. They also might not have some of the knowledge of products and incentives that may be out there, and they may not be certified to give you all the incentives that are out there. Then you have your large companies, companies that cover the whole state. In general, these companies are usually good. Some of the drawbacks of a larger company, maybe their pricing may not be as good. Sometimes they have good pricing, but their customer service isn't good. They don't really give you the customer experience you're looking for. Sometimes you call them and they say, press 1 for sales, press 2 for customer support. And you know, for me, I don't like to deal with a company that handles things that way. I like one-on-one attention. I find most customers do. If that is something that's important to you, then I don't suggest the big national companies. If customer support is important to you, then I really think you would be disappointed to choose a larger company. Again, I've worked with one of these companies. I can speak from firsthand experience what it's like for the customer experience and from an employee's experience. Another issue, which is sometimes dependent on company size, but sometimes not, are the local incentives. In Massachusetts, there are certain incentives like the Massachusetts Solar Loan and the income-based rebate that you have to be an expedited installer to get those incentives. Many of the larger companies cannot participate in those programs. And that holds true for some of the smaller companies. They're not established enough. They don't have the licensing. They haven't been through the proper vetting to participate in some of those programs. I'm going to talk a little bit more on this later on, but it's an important point just to bring up right now. Question number 2, and this one seems obvious, but it's good to ask. What do your customers say about you? See what your solar consultant or the sales rep says. Are they going to be quick to pull up their online reviews on Google or Yelp? Do they have really good testimonials or customers genuinely seem happy that they worked with that company? Now, I will say take some of these with a grain of salt. Obviously, it is a lot easier for people to write negative reviews than it is positive. So don't let one bad review deter you from working with that company. Try to look at several reviews and see what they say. Also, keep in mind, a very big company may have a lot of reviews. And that doesn't mean they're necessarily better than some of the smaller companies. They may not have the resources to chase customers down to get reviews. I know some companies are terrific with this. I know other companies that are terrific are not terrific with getting reviews. So I don't think that should be your only criteria. Again, this is one of 10 different questions you should ask the installer. Obviously, see a whole bunch of negative reviews, then I think that should be a sign that perhaps you should look elsewhere. Number 3, what is the core competency of that company? Are they a solar company? Are they an HVAC company that's trying to transition into solar? Is this someone who is a financial guru who likes the payback of solar, is entering the industry but doesn't really know much about solar? Is it a former solar consultant who started his own sales company? Each of these, again, have their benefits. I will tell you, with the complexity of solar, I'd suggest work with a company that is a solar company. Now, there are solar companies these days that are going to offer heating and cooling and other services. In general, I've seen some companies do this well. I will say most do not do it well. Number four, what brands of solar panels and inverters do you offer? Some companies will only offer one or two solar panels, while other companies may offer a large selection. I really see there's two types of sales models here, and this is something to sort of keep an eye out for. I think by hearing this question, you'll be prepared. Some companies will just have a limited or no product selection. The other type of companies, I like to refer to them as brand agnostic. They are constantly looking at the market, evaluating which solar panels, which inverters are best, and they're really trying to select the right solar panel and the right inverter for that house. That's much, much different than they have one panel, one inverter. In general, I will say a lot of the bigger companies will only offer one solar panel, or maybe two, but you don't have a choice, and one inverter. Some of the smaller companies, they actually don't have the resources to have that product knowledge. So they're just gonna offer whatever is the easiest for them, or perhaps they have a deal to get a special price on a particular panel. And this is something I have noticed, and I've actually thought a lot about this. If we could get a great deal on, let's say, one panel, you can look at our top 10 solar panels of 2020 list. I'll put that link below. But let's say we could get a great deal on one of those panels. Does that mean we should only offer that because we can get a great price on it? Some companies get stuck. They'll buy a whole container full of solar panels. So they're kind of forced into selling you that product. Keep in mind, you and your neighbors, you don't drive the same cars. You don't have the same televisions in your living room. You probably don't have the same exact cell phones in your pocket. Having the same solar panels may not make sense either. Let me give you an example. Let's say the solar panels on your home are going to be on the front of the house and you use a lot of power, but your roof isn't too big. You may want the most efficient and the best looking solar panel on the market, right? Well, meanwhile, your neighbor's panels are on the back and they have a very big roof. So they don't really care about the aesthetics as much and they don't need the highest efficiency. They just want something that's a good price. I can tell you, typically, those are two different solar panels. So when you're working with that solar company, are they looking to give you the best panel and the best inverters for your home, or are they simply not giving you a choice? A couple of questions you can ask your installer that'll help you determine if they're just trying to pigeonhole you into one product, or if they really do have a wide open selection and they're trying to find the right fit for you, are what other solar panels do you offer? Another one is, why do you offer this particular product over another? What are the advantages of this panel over another panel? You can ask similar questions for the inverters. Why did you choose that inverter over a different inverter? What are the advantages of that product over the other one? For racking, I would say it's less important. There are actually really only about three or four major racking and mounting products used by most solar companies, and all of them are very good and very comparable. I would even say if someone tries to tell you that their racking is superior to another company, I kind of don't believe that. Someone would really have to try to convince me of that because I've just seen so many. They're just almost the same. Number five, are you offering any special promotions or programs? This is really important because some companies, for example, a national company may not be able to offer local incentives, whereas a local installer who's gone through the proper vetting and has the proper licenses can offer you a program like that. For example, the Massachusetts Solar Loan can only be offered by solar turnkey integrators in Massachusetts. Similar for the Massachusetts Income-Based Rebate Program. I've met with customers personally who have gotten two or three proposals and they said, well, you're the first company that's even asked me or even showed me this rebate. Now, obviously, in different parts of the world or different jurisdictions, those incentives may be different. So it's important to try to get to the bottom of this. Are there any other incentives or special incentives that you guys offer? Number six, do you do your own installation work or do you subcontract it out? Again, this will tell you about the type of company you're working with. Now, just because a company does not do their own installation work doesn't mean that they don't work with some really good installers. Here at Reyes Solar, we actually install for some smaller companies or some sort of one-man operations. And I think that's fine if they have good relationships. In the past, we've worked with other companies to install for us, especially when we've needed help. At the end, I just think it's important for you to know who's going to be in your home and who's doing the work. Number 7, can you show me examples of your work? Now, if it's me and someone asks me that and I'm the type of person who is a creative person or proud of what I've done, right? I'm going to be very excited to show you photos and to talk about it. I'll talk about why and how our installations are done better. You know, this is true for anything. If your child paints a picture, you know, and it looks nice, you're going to be excited to show people, right? Because if something's quality or you believe in it, you're excited to talk about it. If alternatively, if you work with a company and they're not immediately trying to show you their photos and tell you why their installations are done different than other companies, then that's a bit of a red flag, right? And where this question really is meant to lead is, how is that solar system going to look on your roof? What do I mean by that? If a solar system is done properly, you should see the solar panels. What you should not see is a bright metal junction box, silver junction box next to the system. If you drive around, you may see systems like that. There is no need to put that junction box besides the solar system. It can go underneath it. Panels are naturally lifted off the roof for airflow purposes, so there's always space to a surface mount or a rail mounted junction box underneath that. Similarly, you don't want to see silver metal pipes running every which way all over your house. That drives me nuts. It like breaks my heart to see those things. There are better ways to run the pipe. Sometimes you can just run a pipe right into the attic and then punch out the side where no one sees it, or sometimes keep all the piping and wiring inside the house. So you really want to find out how this install is going to look. So when you're asking to see their work, you're trying to figure out, how's it going to look on my house? And that's also the time to ask them questions. Where are you going to put the equipment? And ask them, do I have a say on where their equipment's going to be? Do I have a say on where we run that pipe? Now, keep in mind, solar installations are subject to national electric code. There are some restrictions, but really what I'm trying to say is they should be open to having those discussions with you. And number 8, can you please describe your project management process? Now, out of everything in this video, out of everything we're going to talk about today, I think this is the one topic and the one question. If you're working with a company that doesn't do this well, it will be the difference between a great experience and a dreadful experience. What am I talking about? You want a company that is going to be making sure they're doing the design quickly, that they're communicating with you, communicating the steps when things are approved, that they're letting you know what they need paperwork or you sign something. There should be a really good communications and flow there. Now, different companies do this differently, so you can sort of inquire into this. Some companies will have a project management department, so you just call up and you'll say, hi, my name so-and-so, can I speak to someone about my project? Now, you might not have a point person, but they'll have a department who handles it. Now, other companies, what they'll do is they'll have a dedicated project manager or a rep assigned to you. I think this is a better model. With that model, you have accountability. You have that person's direct contact information, their phone, their email. If there's ever a problem, you know who to call. If something really does go wrong, you know who is accountable, who to complain about, right? Now, some companies, they don't even have project management because they're not big enough. They may have their solar consultant or, you know, the sales guys actually handling permits. Now, if you asked me as a salesperson, you know, what is the status of the utility permit? I have no clue, right? I'll say, okay, let me talk to your project manager. If it is a salesperson handling that, you know, I question if they have the authority or even the experience to know how to handle those things or the time, right? Number 9, once my system is installed, what can I expect for operations and maintenance? Some companies are going to install and they're never going to look at that system again. You really want to listen in to how they're doing it. Ask them questions. Is someone going to be monitoring my system every day? Now, what do I mean by that? If a company has hundreds of installs, they're not literally looking at every system every day. But what they're doing is they're checking their monitoring portal every day. If there's ever an error or something's not working, that system error will show up at the top and usually also send an email to the company letting them know something's wrong. In our company, we do have someone who checks those portals every single day. I really think that's the best model. If something does go wrong, who do you call? Now, this is also true for project management, for operations and maintenance after. Do you get a point person? At Raya Solar, every step along the way, whether it's the sales process or project management, or if it's what we call solar care after, you have a dedicated person, you'll have their direct contact information. So if there's ever an issue, you know who to call. Some companies, even if they have a solar care or some sort of operations and maintenance division, you call them, it'll say, press 1 for sales, press 2 for support, press 3 for what, something. You know, nobody likes a system like that. I can say I don't like it. And you don't feel like there's accountability. You don't feel like there's someone who's actually looking out for you. Between project management and operations and maintenance, this is the difference between a company that's going to give you a great experience in the beginning and for years to come to a company that's going to make you pull your hair out because you can't get someone on the phone. Because again, I mentioned this in the beginning. With solar, you have inverters, you have communications board, you have sensitive electronics. In reality, over 20 to 25 year period, things go wrong. Sometimes it's as simple as like an internet issue and your solar care or the person who's handling the service will say, okay, they'll be on the phone with you. Unplug the communications device, plug it back in. It's like talking to a cable person. But that's a big difference between your system's not communicating and you don't have anyone to talk to and the system's down for weeks. So I think you get what I'm saying with this. Having that great operations and maintenance is so important. So really try to find out how that company handles these things. Number 10, what are your warranties and guarantees? Now, in the industry right now, there's some pretty standard warranties. It used to be in Massachusetts, the state, the Mass Clean Energy Center, required that installation companies offered a 5-year workmanship warranty. It was a limited workmanship warranty. And that's really expanded over time. Originally, those warranties, they didn't even involve leaking. They were just involved that the system was operating. So obviously, you want a solar company that's going to guarantee that the roof's not going to leak, right? So I would say the minimum installation warranty you should look for is 10 years. Some companies now will offer 20 and 25 year installation warranties. And just to be clear, this is different than the 25 year solar panel warranty. So if the fuses blow, the wiring, you know, something happens with the wiring or some other minor issue that isn't the solar panel, you want to make sure all those things, the roof leaking, you want to make sure all these things are covered by the installation warranty. In addition, companies will offer production guarantees. So you want to find out if they have a production guarantee. This is not as common. I mean, every company is going to definitely offer your installation warranty. Usually some companies will offer what's called a 90% or 95%. So again, if they promise you to use easy math, 10,000 kilowatt hours and 90%, they're going to guarantee 9,000 kilowatt hours that year. Or 95% would be 9,500 kilowatt hours. And the time length of those warranties can vary, anywhere from 5 years to 20 years. You really want to look at those differences as well. And I'll also say, from my experience, sometimes the warranties and those production guarantees are a bit negotiable. So those are 10 questions you can ask your solar company. Bonus question, and this is something that's near and dear to my heart. What is the belief of that company? What is their mission? What are their goals? And if they say something to you like, well, we're a solar company, we're trying to save the planet. Well, to me, that feels a bit generic, right? Doesn't feel like they've put too much thought and probably not too much effort into that. There's a big difference between that and let's say Apple, who says, we want to make products that are easy for our users, that enhance their lives. Like, that to me makes sense, right? Does that mission resonate with you? Does it make sense? Here at Raya Solar, our mission is bringing humanity to light. What does that mean? For us, it's very meaningful. It means that the humanity part is you're bringing that customer service, that personal touch into the experience of bringing someone to light, to solar. We try to implement that by having goals of integrity, punctuality, and other goals like that. So really try to find out, what is this company's mission? Now, there are some companies that they're B Corps, and they have a mission to do good, and they donate a certain percentage of their money to charities. If you hear something like that, you may say, wow, that sounds really cool. I'm so happy to work with a company like that. Another company may say something that you can tell they're kind of making up or really isn't important to them. And I think sometimes that's the difference between choosing, you know, a great company that fits you and just choosing any company. So in the end, what are you really trying to figure out when you're trying to choose a solar company? I would say you want to find a company that's designing and building a system that fits your home and your needs. It's not one size fits all. Does this company really understand the industry? Do they understand the products, the incentives? Are they truly experts? Can they explain the cash flow analysis of a solar system to you in a way that makes sense? Can they explain net metering to you in a way that makes sense to you? In the end, there really shouldn't be any mystery in a solar project. I think that's the obligation of the solar provider. I'm gonna say it. You've bought homes before, but you probably haven't bought solar. and it is the solar company's obligation to demystify solar to you. My closing thoughts on this are, some things are negotiable and some things are not. Price is negotiable sometimes. Maybe the length of a warranty, maybe certain equipment or certain, you know, things that come with the system can be negotiable, but customer service cannot. If a company provides a great quality workmanship, that's not really negotiable. You can't convince someone who doesn't do a good job to all of a sudden do a good job on your install. You can't convince someone who doesn't pick up the phone is going to ignore phone calls when there's an issue to all of a sudden pick up the phone. So really consider what's negotiable and what's not. The things that are negotiable, try to work with the companies that you like. The things that aren't, try to look for those red flags and you can quickly knock those companies off your list and make some great selections. Again, if you're, let's say you got it down to two companies or two or three companies, and one company has great products, you like their customer service, great reviews, you know, from everything you see, they're gonna be there during project management, they're gonna be there 5 years from now when something has an issue with the system, they're going to give you personal attention, and another company is just offering some panel at a low price and they got supposedly the, you know, they got a million year warranty. Identify the things you can negotiate, but at the end, sometimes it's worth it to spend a little bit more money. I know for me, I've been using Apple computers for many years. I know it's a little bit more money than buying a regular laptop, but to me it's worth it because of the quality. I know what I'm getting with it. I think the same is true for most things in life. Look at the value, look at the quality over just the price. No, in the end, sometimes I think the way you start an experience with the company is going to be a great indicator on how things will proceed in the future. And in the end, I would say when all else fails, I would say trust your gut. Go with the company that just feels right to you. If when all else is the same, just trust your gut. And I think that will lead you to having a great solar installation that you can enjoy and save money with for years to come. Thank you for watching this video. I really appreciate it if you made it all the way to the end. I hope you're gonna choose a great solar company and have awesome solar panels in your house. You're gonna save money, you're gonna be happy about it. You're gonna be proud to show your neighbor this great installation, you know, that's done right without pipes on the roof everywhere. So if this video helps you select a company and they do a great job, I'd love to hear that feedback. Again, please subscribe, I really appreciate it. With hope and sincerity, thank you for watching this video on how to choose a solar installer and 10 questions you can ask a solar company. Thank you.